From VisitMySmokies.com, it's the Funcast for the first weekend in March. There is a view from along I-40 in Tennessee. That's the way that a lot of people arrive when they're coming to the Smokies. I'm your Smoky Mountain meteorologist, Paul Poteet, and a lot of people arrived last year at the Smokies. We have some of the final numbers in now. It's a record. In the year 2020, you're sitting down, 12,095,720 visitors. Only the second time in park history that it's been more than 12 million visits in a year. The other time was 2019. Now, there were a few more visits that year than there were in 2020. However, monthly records were set every single month last year in August, September, October, November, and December. Obviously, the park was closed for about a month and a half earlier in the year, but the roads, the trails, the campgrounds, if you were anywhere around the Smokies, especially in the fall, you know that it was even busier than normal. Welcome back. We appreciate it. There are so many reasons why people come to the Smokies, and it's so popular. There are things to do in the great outdoors, and there are a lot of great indoors attractions, too, in the Smokies. One of the famous attractions in the Smokies, as a matter of fact, is about to open for the season. And we've got that covered for you. What is new at Dollywood this year? Well, they've done some work on a lot of the really popular rides. Lightning Rod, for example, has gotten some improvements to its structure. Blazing Fury has some track updates also. Over the last few off seasons, they've been keeping that ride up to par. The people at the park say that a lot of guests wanted more room to walk around and sit and eat food. So there are several walkways that have been extended and expanded. And the Flower and Food Festival is returning to Dollywood this year. That will be going on from April 23rd to June 7th. There's a new concert series that's a part of that also this year at Dollywood. And that's called Melodies of Spring. It's going to have contemporary Christian artists, Southern gospel groups, other artists too. Some names including Matthew West, Big Daddy Weave, The Martins, The New Respects, and the Harlem Gospel Travelers, all coming this year to Dollywood. And if you go to our Things to Know section and just hit that button, you'll see a recent article that's all about five things you really need to know about Dollywood ticket prices, because we don't want you to have to spend any more money than you have to. I'll tell you what, there's inflation and then there's temperature inflation. The pattern over the next week or so in the Smokies is for warmer air to work its way in. And so after this weekend, which is a little bit cooler than average, we're on the up and up in my 7-day forecast. And look at all that sunshine. The entire forecast is completely dry. We're doing fine on precipitation this year, so no reason to feel guilty about all those nice days. Around 50 this weekend, around 60 by Tuesday, and then closing in on 70 by Wednesday of next week. After that, once we get into Friday of next week and into next weekend, I think it's going to be busier as far as the weather goes, and there are going to be several days where we get some rain. There will be so many days ahead for you to have fun when you visit mysmokies.com.